Hey, welcome to the last What the Fuck Sutter for season four. forgive me, I'm getting over tuberculosis. Want to thank the fans, Suns fans, for an awesome season and showing up like you did, and your passion and commitment, and really looking forward to you know, running towards the finish line in these hopefully next three seasons with you guys. I will say I wrote a blog yesterday or the day before about some of the critical analysis, just in general, really, in the blogosphere, and my sort of love-hate relationship with critics and reviewers and bloggers. And and I read an article today that was actually, and forgive me, I don't forget the name of the journalist, but I can actually tweet the site. And it was basically discussing the very issue of the episode-by-episode critical analysis of TV shows, and how, you know, it's changing the dynamic between artist and critic, and in this case, you know, critic and showrunner, and really the pressure of that sort of scrutiny. And, you know, for a guy like me who is, you know, probably way too invested in my own work, and you know, way too oversensitive and alcoholic about all those things, it's really difficult for me sometimes to just detach, you know, and trust my instincts sometimes. So you know, it is frustrating, and I mean, the good news is that ultimately I tend to react and then I'm able to detach from it, and not have it impact me creatively. That's, you know, that's the truth. And I know obviously there's some mixed feelings about the split episode, the split finale, and with fans and critics. And you know, I wrote a follow-up email today to Seppenwall. To Alan, whom I spoke to yesterday, did a post-mortem with him. You know, one of the reasons why I talked to Alan, you know, I sort of shut Alan out of the process, and quite honestly, I felt, you know, Alan was, you know, was the critic for my hometown paper for a long time. The Ledger, in Newark Ledger, and you know, so I felt, I guess I felt this sort of hometown connection to the dude, and so maybe I tend to take his criticism or opinion with a certain amount of give it a certain amount of weight than perhaps other critics. So I've kind of always had this push pull relationship with the dude, and I do think he's a smart guy, and but I you know, honestly, I have felt like his reviews, like a lot of other critics as well, have shifted and changed a little bit in this this atmosphere of instantaneous coverage and getting you know, and getting your blog and posts up first to beat out the other guy. And you know, I just feel like everybody is sort of suffering from this, and you know, and when I shut him down from the process, you know, I guess I felt a little, you know, sort of betrayed by the dude, and that's my stuff. And then I felt like his review of the finale, although I believe it was his opinion and it's it was his truth, you know, it just felt it just felt kind of weighted, and suddenly the dynamic between the two of us just felt like it just became very personal, And, you know, nobody benefits from that dynamic, so it was my intention to really just sort of clear the air and talk to the dude and let him do his job and then ultimately, you know, allow myself to do my job. And that's the deal. And, you know, I sent him an email today and thanking him and with a sort of follow-up insight, and I think I want to share that with folks and then explain that if I could. And forgive me, I know this is going to be a long what the fuck Sutter, but it's I promise it'll be my last one.